presentations of the various ministries of Government of India, Ad Hoc Task Force on Memorandum of Understandings, Government of India. He has been on the boards of many public and private sector enterprises. He's the advisory panel on corporate governance and has considerable experience of teaching and guiding research for doctoral degree in management, economics, public administration, and commerce. He is on the editorial boards of many national and international journals and publications brought out by publishers of repute from India and abroad. Friends, we are glad to have such a wonderful director with us, and I request our director to welcome the guests.
Respected Krishna Iyer ji, respected Ramakrishna ji, Professor Murthy, Dean of IPE, my colleagues there, Karuna and friends. First, let me extend a very, very warm welcome to all those who have joined the first semester and who are going to be with us in the fourth semester. I am very sure the 2 years you are going to be with us, for those who have joined the first semester and those who are going to complete their studies in 16-17, it will be a marvelous time. I'm sure all of you are happy. Are you happy, yes or no? Why should we be happy? I think that's a very moot question. We should be happy because we are working on the objectives which we have to achieve through this course. We are going to produce a genre of young people who are very bright, a genre of people who will contribute to the growth of this state, to the growth of our country, and will also bring peace and prosperity to the world. Friends, as management students, you have come here not to do a 2-year course only. You have to go far beyond that. These days, we have been talking of sustainable development. United Nations have come out with their goals, 17-pronged goals, which we have to achieve by 2030. And as management students there, and as management students on this side, we have to work together to undergo a responsible management education. Now, what could be that responsible management education? That's very, very important. One is, we should know and we should ask this question every day to us. This is, should be our Gita, this should be our Quran, this should be our Guru Granth Sahib, this should be our Bible, or any religion you talk. Our religion is, we are students here. Every day when we sleep, we should ask, did we add any value? God gave us 24 hours. What did we do with those 24 hours? We have taken breaths. Every minute, you know, we are breathing. Every second, we are breathing. What we have been doing with, you know, those breaths? You ask whether that day, did you go to class? Did you attend your classes? Did you take notes? Did you go to library? Did you go to, go for a search on internet? How many journals you read? What the classic article that you read on that? What is the field study that you like to do? What is the difference between good schools and not so good schools? The difference is very, very small, but that, you know, makes very big things. One is that boys who are in very good schools, they don't only think, but they also try to see how they can implement those concepts in practice. That is one. Number two, boys in good schools, they, as I told you the other day, they become managers not after passing the course. The moment you join the course, you are a manager. So you have to have those qualities in you, whether you will be able to support your seniors when you go to industry, what kind of support you will give, can you access databases, can you write a good note, can you do a good analysis, can you do a good financial analysis? There are so many questions that you should be asking. Because in India, if you go to Indian philosophy, we always say we should be questioning. That is the Socratic way. You must have heard of Socrates. What was the Socrates philosophy? Socrates philosophy was, each minute you ask a question to yourself. And don't stop there. Keep on asking questions. So friends, I welcome you. Today, I am speaking in this loud tone. Why? because I see Mr. Krishnan Iyer here. An epitome of a vibrant leader, an epitome of a person who has vitalized, you know, our industry, who has brought a big name. A person, when he walks, people start moving, people become positive in thinking. He has all professional qualifications and he has taught. There is no professional qualification where Mr. Krishnan Iyer has not taught. He has taught his charter accounting, he has taught his cost accounting, charter secretaryship, then, you know, management accounting from abroad. And he has been in number of enterprises. I know only once, a few, but he was in GE holding very high positions. He was in IBM holding very high positions. He is in Cognizant holding second or third position in India. And he was also chief of the Bank of Switzerland, you know, BIS we call them, Bank of Switzerland. He was heading that too. All the people who have worked with Mr. Krishnan Iyer, they always talk very positive and so much about him. It is our great fortune. He is a very busy person, but one thing I found in him, he has never told no to me whenever I requested him to come over here. Each hour cost is in lakhs of rupees for the company. But he knows that when he talks to youngsters, he is creating millions, I think, for the company and also for the country. We need, I think, such people like Mr. Krishnan Iyer, who can energize, who can be, you know, seen as a role model, who can be seen as people who are building this modern economic India, a great power, which is growing at 8%, which may leave even China behind, I think, in no time. A country where managers believe not only in making money, adding value, but they also believe in ethics, right? When you talk of corporate governance, my colleague was talking about the Asian chapter of the corporate governance. I think if anybody has to learn corporate governance, he has not to go anywhere. He has to go and see how Mr. Krishnan, how he conducts himself in the industry. He's a living example of someone, you know, which can always inspire you all the time, whether you're awake or you're asleep. Please give a big round of applause to Mr. Krishnan. I am happy not only for you, but for the entire faculty, because by coming here, Mr. Krishnan Iyer is adopting us and taking us to his fold. So now I think, you know, we have a steward, I think, we have a leader who not only helps the industry, you know, IT industry in the country and making it international, but who is also adopting, I think, you know, our young people, very, very bright people who have come from all India tests. Most of them are throughout first class. Most of them, they have come through competitive examinations and they have so much vigor. And I'm very sure that after 2 years, when we meet, sir, when you come again, their success will go through this roof. Friends, on that occasion, let me also welcome Mr. Ramakrishna. Mr. Ramakrishna deals with management education not only in India, but in 7 countries of our South Asia. He is executive director of MDSA, Association of Management Development Institutes in Asia, and he is concerned with the quality of management education in not only India, but in Asia. About 250 leading institutes, including all IIMs, all IITs, all institutes in Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Maldives, Nepal, topmost institutes are members of the MDSA Association. MDSA is also connected to EFMD, European Foundation for Management Development. I think I can announce that Mr. Ramakrishna and MDSA has been very kind to give IPE the label of SACS, South Asian Quality System of Accreditation. There are not many institutes in the 7 countries which have this label, and we have to earn this label through a very arduous and long process. We have to wait for about 4 years on that, but we have passed through all the stages and we are awarded this level about 1.5 years back. We have to continue to work to retain that label. But then SACS is also a way to get to EFMD, European Foundation for Management Development. They're the highest accreditation in the world, and we are taking guidance from him And I hope we'll move forward, and the day is not very far. That is next 4 to 5 years, because EFMD takes about 8 to 10 years. We have started working in the direction under his guidance, under the guidance of MD sir. Maybe in 7 to 8 years, we'll have that label too. Mr. Ramakrishna is particularly, you know, concerned about the growth and development of IP. He takes a lot of interest in suggesting to us as to how we can improve our pedagogy, how we can improve our content of research, how we can be publishing, how we can have a better interface with industry, how we can have more case studies, and he's connecting us to all the best schools of the world. We are also working in that direction with ISB, and I'm sure that very soon you'll have the ISB DG also coming over here and talking to you. Sir, this week, I think we are changing the method of management education in this institute, and we'll try to bring as many industrialists as possible to the institute. So you have seen that first week, you have only top doyens of the industry coming to IP. We'll have one more intervention like that within a semester. We'll again repeat this, you know, sometime, you know, before midterm test or after midterm test, where you don't see our faces. You see our faces who are teachers here only for a few minutes, but then at the center stage would be those who have been leading industry. We want to make IPE is already number one in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. We are number 7 in the country, much beyond IITs and many IIMs which have come during last 8 to 10 years. Out of 19 IIMs, we are at 7th or 8th position. But I'm very sure in the next 4 to 5 years, we'll build up an IPE which will be an institutional repute, which already is an institutional repute, but which will be floating, I think, you know, at level 1, 2, or 3, you know, in India, and maybe it may be the India's face, I think, you know, in South Asia and in the world. When people talk about management education, they'll talk about IP. And I say that with great strength. For one thing, IP is the only institute where teachers are involved in training. We train CMDs of enterprises, we train GMs of enterprises, the best enterprises in the petroleum industry, best enterprises in steel making, the best enterprises in the electricals, all of them, they come to IP, the best governors of RBI. 3 governors have been trained, you know, by IP. Dr. Y.V. Reddy, who people talk so much about him, Dr. Mr. Subbarao, my own teacher was Dr. Rangarajan, who taught me long back. You have trained 3,000 IS officers, we continue to train. Our colleagues, they go and they sit in IS selections. They sit in many important selections. Most of them have been abroad. They have taught abroad. Most of them have published in international journals. Most of them have very large projects from national and international institutions. And IP's Connect is there with the topmost institutions in the world. And as a part of government's faith in IP, IP was chosen to assess the performance of all the ministries of the government of India, all the secretaries. Secretaries, you know, you become secretary just at the fag end of your IS career. So IP was evaluating the performance of 69 secretaries, excepting defense, external affairs, and finance. So maybe finance has 5 secretaries. In all, you remove 10 secretaries, about 69 to 70 secretaries, their performance was being evaluated by IP. This gives, you know, IP a very different kind of, you know, strength. IP is just not an institute where you come and take an examination, you get some marks, you cram some books, or you write something out. No. Here you come with a greater vision, you become manager of aspirations. You know, what is the difference, I told the other day, between a dead tree and man? Difference is only one, aspirations. Here we have young people who have aspirations. Here we have young people who want to create an entrepreneurial India. Here we have young people who believe in innovations. Here we have young people who believe in responsible management education. Here we have young people who believe in sustainable development. I'm very sure when you go out, the portals of IP, you will be one like that. You are getting 2 years' time. And 2 years' time, I think, is an adequate time to transform and change yourself. And I'm very sure people, when you see, when you look at Mr. Krishnan Iyer, when you look at Mr. Ramakrishnan, I don't think any force on the earth can prevent you from becoming one like them. On that note, I once again welcome both our distinguished guests, Mr. Krishnan Iyer and also Mr. Ramkrishnan. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your welcome address.